Rainedge, the name, came in to give a good, a hope to those that are vulnerable and looked down upon in the community. So basically that's who we are. We give hope to those that are not able to have a life, have an education, have shelter, and basically we deal with children. So we raise children that are from either the streets or those that have been shunned by the community and their families. My husband suggested an idea of getting street boys and girls from the streets. So we'll get several vans and bring them out for feeding, give them a haircut, give them a change of clothes, and then take them back into town. But after a couple of months, a few of them, about 10 to be precise, they said, no, we are not going back. We had a big shed. I would call it a shed because it was an old house. It didn't have windows, it didn't have doors, no facilities at all, no electricity and no water. But they realized that facility was ours. So they said to us, there may be no kitchen, there may be no windows, but this is better than the streets. And so we had 10 boys to start with. And when we started that, there was no turning back. So the number kept increasing until the current number of 174 boys and girls.
The school has been in place for the past 10 years. It started exactly in the year 2006. The number of boys currently is around 230, while the number of girls we have around 214. Okay, the vision of the school is to better the lives of the pupils. Mostly affected in one way or the other, to make them good citizens in future and people who are responsible in future.
I oversee the teaching. I go through the schemes of work and the curriculum to be covered with the teachers. I attend meetings. I go to different classes at different times to see how the teaching delivery is done, the relationships between teachers and children. I handle complaints from parents. I handle complaints from the teachers as well and from the pupils. So basically, I think I call it I manage the school.
Okay, Rainedge High School is a school with a difference, and this school actually started last year, whereby we had an enrollment in the Form 1 class, and the enrollment was a good number. That is for start, we had around 25 students, and right now we are in the Form 2, we are at the second level, whereby we have the Form 1 of this year, and the enrollment of this year was actually, that is 17 students. And the motto of the school is where hard work brings excellence, and the vision of the school is basically to ensure that we diversify the minds of the learners to greater heights so that they can be competent in whatever they can face outside the institution.
The has a sense of optimism out of the projects that have been initiated with us. Like we're talking of the Akoshua, the water plant. Yeah, we got lots of water where we've meted the community, we build them, we have some money, we got the bottling plant where we actually bottle the water.
We are doing all this to assist our home here, the Shua 24 home. On our label you can see all the profits and all the money goes back to the assisting the children at the Shua 24. So that is how we come into Rainedge, and that's how we intend to assist Rainedge to manage the Shua 24 home through making sure that we get some fun through ourselves here.
We also have a mechanical garage, a small hardware store, making a little bit of money from there. We've started a small tourism farm and creating an opportunity for other kids that are coming out of college and getting to work with that. We've got a shoe chick, which is our most recent one, where we're doing like it's a small restaurant, and you know, like when the kids leave high school, before they get into university, if they qualify for university, they've got to wait for a span of up to 10 months before they join the university. And for us, especially the girl child, it's just like, how do you get them occupied within that time? And Shoe Chick has come in handy, and definitely they've been making amazing food. We've started rearing our own chicken, and eventually, you never know, just expand on that. And we also have the essence of importing secondhand bicycles that we're selling, a bit of computer that we're selling, mobile phones, and it's all about anything you can put your hand on to make a little bit of money to subsidize ourselves, so that at the end of it, we're growing towards becoming self-sustaining. And one of the things that we're doing also is on construction side of things, our own small farm of construction and builders that we've developed over time, and they're doing an amazing job, saving a lot of costs on buildings.
Rainbow Club, it's a program that we run on Saturdays with assistance from LFA teachers. Basically, we come up with lessons which are biblical lessons, and they are day-to-day life. Like, we can come with a lesson talking about challenges. Then we go back, our reference is the Bible. So it's, they are Bible lessons, but with more fun. And that's where we get to know the problems of our children in the community. That's when we bond with these children. We know their problems, because at that time we are friendly, we are all in short, we are all playing together. So it makes us bond together with these children.
Like the opportunity of having some of the young ones and developing a rugby team from the scratches, kids that have come from the dam, and they get an opportunity to play rugby and qualify, get tickets to fly into Britain and play in Britain. That has been an amazing, amazing achievement. And there's no words to express our gratitude for just to see such a success in the life of people who were kind of seen as failures and the underdogs, and now they are just like revered and respected because of just having the opportunity of flying out of the country, out of a small opportunity or doors of opportunity that come their way, and they perform, and there they go. At the moment, the biggest need is in developing our high school, completing the first phase of the high school project. This is a new initiative to do with the high school project, and with the experience that we've had developing our own kids from primary level and getting into high school, taking them to external high schools, we've gotten to a point where we've thought it is smart enough to develop our own high school, which eventually will save us a lot of money. It's under construction, and if we can build this institution together, then it will mean a lot, saving a lot of money, probably up to tens of thousands every semester. And as we can collect some money from different people and also save money in excess of where we've been taking kids to external high schools, because our kids are well performing, and you know, the better they perform in this country, the more expensive it is as they go into these national schools and the like. But if we can still offer that quality and affordable education, it will really mean a lot, because then with the influx of the kids coming out of high school, they'll find a place, and we can continue to give them quality education that we're all looking into.